Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 Real Grade Force Impulse Gundam. And I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam, link is in the description below. So we got the horse blender, the top flyer and the leg flyer, or is it the chest flyer and the leg flyer? Whatever, doesn't really matter. But they can all stand on their own in this mode. I was really surprised about the chest flyer because it has the shield, and there's no landing gear on the chest and leg flyer. But you just gotta kind of move the arm a little bit to the one side, and it stands fine. Now the Chorus Blender does have the landing gear, the missiles, does have an opening cockpit with nobody inside. You do have a little shin figure, very small, which, I don't know, it's a little too big for that cockpit, but whatever. But it does it pretty good. So, transformation is essentially the same as it usually is. Just gotta remove the landing gear and the missiles. Tail fins go back. These don't go in like they do in the Mastery, they just slide down. And then the nose cone still doubles over. And it kind of locks into place, like once it gets down where it's supposed to go for mobile suit mode. And then legs are also the same, I mean they're pretty simple. Once again, they do have a locking point kind of, once they go into this mode they kind of lock, and then they come out. So that's good, they don't flop around in the mobile arm mode. And then, this is a little different. Where on the Mastery there's like a little red lash that comes out, this whole red part comes out. And then it allows you to take the nose cone and slide it into there, and then you push the red over it, and it locks it in place. That's a really cool idea. It's very neat. I think it's much better than the Mastery, which that part I usually forget about because it really doesn't seem to do much. And then with the torso, you gotta, there's no dedicated hinges for the, like, they have to slide out. On like a track that the Masquerade has, which I think is fine because this just gives it more articulation. And of course that also important chest plate that covers the face because it's important for some reason. And I like the fact that it has this extra piece that you rotate on the arm, which does help in this mode. And I'm just gonna swap out the hands. And get rid of the shield for now. And it just slides down into place, pegs in, and that is the Impulse Gundam in his mobile suit mode. And looking fantastic. This thing looks great. I love it. Way more than the Mastery. Like, the Mastery is good, but I gotta say, this feels kind of like the XC of Real Grade, where it is a superior Mastery, because there's been enough time since the Mastery came out that they made quite a few advances, and the Real Grade really does, I feel, pull off the whole Impulse way better in terms of the construction and what transformation it has. And the only stickers I use were for the cameras, as usual. Although you do have a fairly large sticker sheet if you do want to use it. There's quite a bit there. You do have the cockpit that can come up, but I can never get in there. It's sunk in. Oh, I did it. That just has like the trap door, like the door that opens up, the double door, pretty much. And it does look pretty good. It does have a little bit of a two-tone look, I believe. It looks like it to me here, especially on the arms. Lower arms are slightly lighter, or slightly darker than the white on the rest of it. Same thing with the side skirts here, the panel. But yeah, it's a nice, stiff kit. I really like it. This is definitely my favorite version of the Impulse so far. Although I am a little worried about these V-fins. This one here was kind of bent once I started, before I even touched it. I don't know if you can tell. It's kind of warped a little bit. So I'm a little worried about that breaking if it somehow falls off the shelf, but for the most part. Great cat. So the head is ball jointed. Pretty good. It does have a hinge, a fore and a back. The arms have that double hinge it was using to help with the transformation, so we can actually come out all the way. And then it can hinge forward. And also go up. And then the arm here can go up about that far. It does kind of stop, but it has this piece here. The shoulder part actually hinges by itself, so it kind of gets out of the way when you want to get the arm up. Because I guess if you didn't, it would, that bulky part of the arm would hit it like right there. But because it hinges, it can go up just a little bit more. So I guess that helps. Of course, it rotates and rotates with the shoulder. You got a nice double jointed elbow. Let me get the arm back in the torso there. You have that rotation I mentioned at the lower part of the arm. They have a ball jointed wrist. And even though it has a whole transformation, this is another thing that is superior to the Master Grade. They really dedicated a joint in the chest to give it some more articulation. Right there in the chest, look at that. Separate from the actual midsection of the blue. So we can hinge forward at the torso. And it doesn't affect the combination. It works just the same as it always did, and even better if you ask me. So, really good. They have the rotation at the waist. Front skirts are separate on ball joints. Side skirts are ball jointed. Back skirts are ball jointed. And the legs, they can hinge down. That is weird. Oops, the legs is actually easier to see. They have it hinged together so they can come down. And they lock into place once you get them up all the way. So you could utilize that for even more articulation. But without doing that, it goes that far forward. Although if you bring it down, it goes that far forward, which I guess is a little bit more. And then that far back. Out to the side all the way. Oops. Until the side skirt pops off. So about that far. Rotates at the thigh. You've got a nice double jointed knee. Oops. That side skirt's being a pain in the bum, but that's okay. Okay, maybe it's not. Just stay on, please. There we go. And the ankle armor is ball jointed at the front. And then the foot itself can tilt side to side up here in the like leg. It's a little different. And then you have forward and backward at the foot. And the toes can move down and up because of the transformation. And there's a little bit of rotation. Not a whole bunch. And there's also the tilting at the foot itself. So it can tilt at the ankle and the foot. So that does give it a pretty good ankle tiltage. So it does have pretty good articulation. And the fact that it has that chest joint, even though it does have the whole combination, is really great. They definitely exceeded what the Master Grade could ever do. So yeah, really good articulation. So we got quite a few hands. We got the standard real great hands of balled up fists that are kind of small. We have holding hands with pegs inside them. And then we have a pair of open hands as well. And then we have a trigger finger hand for the right hand, which also has a peg in it for the beam rifle. Which does look good. Has the movable sensor, which does have a white piece at the end. Movable extra handle. You got a flip-out peg, so you can store it on the back skirt. Pretty secure, especially if you pulled off the end piece. And thankfully, that did not break. I thought it might once it popped off. So that's good. Credit to the construction. And it just goes right in, like that. No problem. And then, of course, we have the shield. Which does a whole opening up, so I always have a time opening these shields up. Yeah, just open the ends, and then open up the middle parts. And I always feel that they should open farther than they do, but that's just the way the design of the actual shield. I feel like they should open a little bit more, but I guess that's always the way it is. But it does look good. I feel that the holes here should be a little bigger because they are meant, I think, like the Freedom, to put the beam rifle through the barrel. Because the Freedom did do that the one time. It sucked the barrel through the hole so that he could shoot while he was blocking. Which is kind of cool. Can't do it here. You got the extra handle that can move, but it's not really necessary because it can easily peg into the arm, which is definitely dedicated. Like, it stands out. It's fine. This goes right in, and of course, once again, because of that rotation there. And also, this part, also, I say that a lot, apparently. But this part moving does help get the shield out of the way, so you can move it without worrying too much about the shoulder armor. I do like that. And you also have the armor, I know they're not armor schneiders, I don't think here, but you have the daggers, which I have pegged into the one hand. They do have a peg hole, so they can securely peg into these holding hands. Very nice. They work really well. And I love the fact that they're actually one-upping the strike real grade, because I don't think I have this, but the tab hole in the dagger actually has a, like, can go into the tab in the sheath. You can see the tab right there. So it's securely fit. You don't have to worry about which way do I put it in so that it actually stays in place. You just peg it in. And there you go. So I really like that. I always have a hard time getting the daggers to stay in the sheaths in the right orientation. And they are collapsible, which is good. So yeah, the daggers, like, are also really well designed. And then finally, we have the Force Pack, the Force Silhouette Pack. Which I guess you can have these down like that if you want. But it does have the Silhouette Booster. And it works pretty much like the Master Grade with a slide-out piece, which I find is also easier to work with than the Master Grade. And you got the little booster there. It looks good. I mean, it doesn't need to be much. But it does, no landing gear, but it does have a hole for a stand. And then the pack, as you saw, the beam rifle handles can move. They're ball-jointed. And the wings have some interesting articulation. They can move back, and then they're ball-jointed at the base. Unfortunately, this is one thing that the Master Grade did do, which I wish this did. The wings don't collapse halfway. They don't fold down. Because I'd rather if they, instead of folding back, I'd rather they fold down and fold in. Just, it looked cool in the Master Grade, and also serves to save space, because here you just, well, it's still going backwards, so it takes a back space. You can do that, though, so that does help. But I do miss that collapsing wing effect. Not a huge deal, but the one thing that's cool that they added here, flip out extra thrusters in the bottom booster pieces. Look at that. That's definitely different. And I really like it. These are ball-jointed. So, the Force Pack has some interesting things. Oh, and the back thruster, another interesting added piece. They move separately. So, there are some new features here that they've added to the Force Silhouette, and a few that they took away. But, you know, it's not a big deal. It just goes into those big ports on the back. Like so. And there is the Force Impulse. It can stand fine, even if you put these back. It can still stand pretty well. It's a little back heavy, but you can get the impulse fine. And of course, these are long enough to act as, like, extra legs, so that you don't have a problem at all. And those, oh, and I can't forget, beam effects for the beam sabers, because of course. And they also have the holes in the handle so they can fit into the tabs and hands. So those are the accessories. It has everything it needs, and they all work great. I have no complaint. Like, my only complaint is that the wings don't fold down in on themselves. They just fold back. But, I mean, you can still kind of work with that. I just, it's a preference of mine, so I can't really complain too much. This is a great kit, really. I think they've already done, have they done the Sword Impulse yet? I might have to pick it up if they have. Because, yeah, I really like the accessories here. So, let's start. I think we'll start with, I'll do the Impulse High Grade, the Revive version. So you can see how they look together, because that's not really that old of a kit. And then we got the Real Grade, so, I mean, if I had to choose, I'd go with the Real Grade for sure. But the High Grade is not that bad, really. It's still a decent kit. And then I'll just compare it to, I want to do the real grade Freedom, but it's kind of far on my shelf, so I think I'll use the Strike Freedom High Grade, actually. Compared with that, because I have my other real grades are kind of compacted on the shelf right now. But that is the real grade Force Impulse Gundam Great Kit. It is one of the best real grades, I feel. It's super solid. Like, there are a lot of real grades out there that feel a little flimsy once you get them together. Because they're trying to do so much on such a small figure. But this one, and also, like, there are other ones, but this the Impulse here and the XE, I feel, are really Master Grade 1.5s, I think. Like, they are even 2.0s. Like, they're so good. They're so much better than their Master Grade counterpart in terms of construction, how they do things, how they add articulation where you wouldn't think they could, and how they hold their accessories way better. So, yeah, this is a great kit. And if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam. And I'll see you in the next review.